Every morning, she woke up to the sun trying to peek through the slats in her shutters and sneak around the corners of her curtains. She would rise up out of the bed, and she would move the curtains to the side, open the windows, push the shutters out, and the sun would come unfiltered, warming her soul. And then she would close those windows and begin to dress for her day. Always when she finished dressing, she picked up her lipstick. Crimson red was what she wore every single day. Then down the stairs she would go as she would fix her hair just a little bit, some moisturizer, as she had red twists on her hair. And at the bottom of the stairs, she would pick up her basket and go out the door. When she went out the door, she went into her community. And there in the community, she listened. She heard. She understood. She advised. She counseled. And when she had gone through her own community, she went to the next community. And she listened and heard and understood and advised and counseled. But as there always is, there were wolves, black, brown, gray, wolves. Wolves that came to stop the way. Sometimes the wolves would see her and they would say something so silly that she would look at them and just laugh as she turned on heel and walked away. Sometimes they would say something so profane that she would look at them and say, "Don't you ever speak to me like that again." And they would turn on heel and walk away. And sometimes they would say something so deeply, deeply troubling that it would scare her. And she would go away from them as fast as she could. But she still went out, wolves or not, into the community, carrying her basket. Inside her basket, she had courage and faith and hope and love and compassion. And she passed this out to everyone she met. And it's probably because of the things in her basket that she didn't recognize when people needed more. Annie Mae, one of those she visited, needed something more substantial than what was in Red Hair's basket. So she went to a wolf. And the wolf promised her to give something more substantial for one price, Red Hair. But Annie Mae was so desperate for this that she agreed. And since it was a friend, Red Hair didn't notice when she knocked on Annie Mae's door. She didn't look into Annie Mae's face and see the concern there. She walked into that entry hallway, babbling along, and she didn't recognize when Annie Mae turned around and locked the door behind her. She had no idea of anything else happening until she got to the living room and saw the wolf. And on that, she turned around and saw Annie Mae standing in front of the door, blocking her way, her head down. It would be some time before Red Hair was able to gather her things and gather herself. But when she did, with her basket on her arm, she went into that entry hall, and there stood Annie Mae, who tried to reach over, and Red Hair cringed from her touch and went to the door and unlocked it herself and ran all the way home. When she arrived at her home, she dropped her basket on the floor, ran up the stairs, but only after she had locked all three locks on her door. She closed the shutters, the window, the curtain, and did not come back out. But she had given from her basket to the community. And the community knew what had happened, and they began to protest. Indeed, they went to the coyote and said, "Coyote, go and turn Wolf in." But Coyote said, "He's not my brother. Am I his keeper?" They went to the bear and asked the bear to take the wolf and put him behind the bars in the cave. But the bear said he had no authority. They went to the judge, Panther, and the panther said he had no evidence. They protested and brought their plea to the eagle of justice, who squawked and flew away. But the people had had what was in that basket. And so they continued. They continued to ask and beg and plead and demand until finally, one day, Coyote got his brother, Wolf, and brought him to Bear. And Bear put him in the cave behind the bars. And Panther Judge brought him before him and pronounced judgment. And Eagle Justice flew down and proclaimed justice throughout the land. And Wolf was gone. Yes, it was only one wolf. And there were so many others. But for this one, they had won. And while they protested, and while they demanded, they did not forget Red Hair. They went to Red Hair's door, and they knocked. And when she did not come, they left gifts, baskets, presents, notes on her door. And they continued to leave what they had, and they waited. It took much time, much, much time before Red Hair could come down those stairs, looking out the peephole to make sure no one was there, unlocking the locks, peeping around the corner, seeing no one, looking at the gifts, pulling them inside, ripping the notes off the door, throwing them in, and then quickly shutting the door and locking the locks again, all three. And still the community came, knocking at her door, leaving when she did not come. It took time for her to open that door to them. And still the community came, knocked on her door, and waited. It took time for her to be able to come down when they knocked and open the door and accept the gift. And even then, she would close it quickly. Then one day, after much, much time, the sun tried to peek through those slates in her shutter and come around the sides of her curtain. And she got out of the bed and she moved the curtain aside and opened the window and threw back those shutters. And the sun came unfiltered onto her, warming her soul. And as she closed the window, she turned to get ready for her day. She went over and she had been given many gifts now. No longer was it just crimson red lipstick. Now she had ruby red, magenta, and hot tamale to choose from. And her hair, well, they had given her extensions to put in her hair. They were red extensions that flowed down her back. Still red hair, just different. And someone had left her a red leather jacket to keep her warm and safe. And she went down her stairs and picked up the basket and put back in the things she had and unlocked the three locks and went out to the community. And there she listened and heard and understood, advised and counseled in her community. And when she was finished in her community, she went to the next community and listened and heard and understood and advised and counseled. But some days, she was tired. And she couldn't go out. But it was okay, because that's when the community came to her with their own baskets.